This is just a little addition to my water distillation video, an update, if you will. I come across a pressure cooker for the cost of a gasket from my neighbor. There's been a couple of people telling me that I should run the pipe up out of the bucket and into another vessel because the water leaking out from around the grommet might get into my purified water. And I've done that. And as soon as I determine the height that this has to be, I'll bend that pipe down. But right now, I'm looking at the top of this pressure cooker. And this is an overpressure blow-off valve, and this is another one, and this is where the weight goes. It's supposed to go down on that. So what I'm going to do is take this out and see if I can. I have a tap that's this size. See if I can tap that hole out and thread this 90 down in there. And that will sure make for a nice, neat, tight setup. So I'm going to get that out right here and see what we got, see what size that hole is. Well, I have to go back to Ace Hardware. I do not have a tap this size. This is the biggest tap I have. That's not quite big enough. So that's where we're going with this. All right, let's take a trip to Ace. It only took a couple hours. Jeez. Half the day is gone, going after parts. And I thought Ace Hardware opened at noon on Sunday, and they opened at 1, so I had to sit out there and wait on them to open for an hour. All right, I got enough parts. Something is going to work. Something. We'll figure it out. I really don't think this is thick enough metal to thread. I mean, you know, you can thread it, but it won't hold. So I got a couple more taps. I'm going to see which one is this size. We'll see. We'll get back to you. All right, that's what we got. It's a T, and I got a cap on this end. And the rubber and a washer on that end. I do believe that's going to be steam tight. I was going to say airtight, but you know what I mean. All right, now, it's really cold out, and what I'm going to do is get an Oh, that's much better, much better. And thank you, whoever it was, that advised me to just run the pipe up over the top and thereby eliminating the need for a hole in the side. That was a good idea. That's a good thing about YouTube. A bunch of people coming together, sharing ideas and making things better. I love it. Alrighty, I'm going to sit back, let this boil, and start circling some seeds. I should have already ordered them, but, you know, if my plants are too late, I'll just buy some plants, put them in the ground, and plant the ones I grew from seed the second time around. I'll see you when this thing starts boiling. Well, it's working, and it's taking about a half an hour to start boiling this little tiny hot plate. It's just barely getting this water boiling. So I don't have a whole lot of drippage, but it would work in a pinch. Tell you what would work better is my Coleman stove. I should have got that out. It would have had this boiling in no time at all. But it's working. That's what the important thing is. And oh, son of a gun, that is hot. It's working. There you go. The pressure cooker is definitely the way to go. Or a canner, a pressure canner. But the pressure cooker gets the water boiling faster, but a pressure canner, if you had a fire you didn't have to tend constantly, would probably be the way to go. Maybe, you know, like setting it on a wood stove or something like that. But or even in a fire, maybe.
But I'm glad I did this. This was a really important experiment to me anyway. Now I have absolutely no fears that in a pinch, in an emergency, in a situation where the utilities that we've all grown used to having, water, electricity, at least water, I can get water and make it 100% safe to drink. And the next thing I'm going to make and show you how to make is a bio sand filter. And there's a ton of science behind that, and I've been researching and reading about that and writing notes on that for about 3 years now. It's not as reliable as distilling, but if you weren't able to distill, in my opinion, it would be the second best thing. All right, thanks for watching, y'all. I'm just going to put this up and have a warm couple of days. It's going to get 16 degrees here tonight. I believe that's a record for us. See ya.